Hey YouTubers, I'm in Round Rock getting ready to do a two-room stretch. So let's take a look around. It's really wrinkled here in one spot. So let's take a look here. There's this wrinkle here. And there's one right here. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to take up the carpet on this wall and this wall, as well as that wall over there, and I'm going to stretch the carpet to the window. What's going to happen over here is this room could be stretched, but we're not going to stretch it. So in order to get the wrinkle out, what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut the doorway open here and I'm going to reseam it. So that's how I'm going to fix that. And then when we get done with that, there is a master bedroom downstairs that is going to get stretched as well, and it's going to be a little more difficult due to the shape and the furniture that's involved in it. So I'm going to do the hardest part last this time rather than first. So I'm going to get up my tools and get to working, and I will check back in shortly. All right, I wanted to catch up, people. I think I've moved these guys 4 times so far, I believe. This is it's exceptionally wrinkled. It's only one wrinkle, but it's difficult to make go away. Basically, I'm using like a full bite with a power stretcher and pulling over, and the carpet is good 10 years old. It's builder grade carpet, so it's soft. It's real stretchy. This is close to being done. This over here still needs a decent amount of stretching done. What I hope hasn't happened is that the top layer released from the bottom layer, and I'm stretching the bottom layer tight and the top layer is not adhered to it. Let's hope that's not the case, because if it is, I'll still fix it. I don't know exactly how I'm going to do it yet, because once I start out into it, I'll find a way. I always have. All right, this is after that, so I will put you guys over here, and I will check back in a little bit. I'm going to pull the carpet some more. All right, guys. Let's take a look here and see what we got. All right. Got it down to here. It is the resemblance of there still being a wrinkle there, but it's not. It's gone. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to see. All y'all can place bids on how much carpet I'm going to get off. It is, by the time I took this in, it's probably not going to be an inch and a half, maybe, I think. But I'm going to add some nails, some stay nails to the floor to hold it, so when I take my stretchers off, it doesn't try to creep back out or something. Shown this before. When you take the power stretcher off, it's got the carpet stretched over, and you've got this big bump you've got to push out, and that's where the knee kicker comes into place. I don't actually do a lot of kicking with it myself. I just put my foot on the carpet and push kind of hard with it. When you kick it, it doesn't necessarily stay as far as you kicked it over. So I just push, because it'll stay as far as I can push it, but it won't stay as far as I can kick it. So it And when it's this, and this is loose as it is now, when you really stretch it like crazy, it kind of makes the carpet almost bubble. So every once in a while, you'll have to you'll get a bubble or something in here, and you'll have to stretch it that way a little bit to pull all of that out. And it happens every once in a while if it's really, really, really loose. And it may be the case here today. I don't know for sure yet. Just watch that wrinkle in the carpet there. See if you can see it. Hell, I can't even see it. Right there. Here. It's hard for me to see. I started using a different camera or something. There we go. That's the wrinkle that's left. I don't know if that way shows it better. Over here, see, because I'm trying to figure it all out by looking at that on my wrist, and that is just a thumbnail. Very difficult at times to sometimes see what I'm trying to film. Maybe I should switch to my vlogging camera again and use that for a while. The wrist remote works on it too. I'm cutting it on and off, but you can actually see through the viewfinder on the camera. You can use that, it's bigger. Put the nails in there, not put in far at all, barely, just stick it through to hold the carpet in place, and they're used over and over and over and over again. The only time I toss one is when once in a while I'll trip over one while I'm working, and then I'll wind up getting it after replace it. The nails are actually carpet tools too at this point. Back on when I cut that piece off. I'm gonna pull my nails up and tuck everything else in. Thank you. should have moved all this before I started cutting. All right. Left a little of it kind of sticking up, so it'd be enough to tuck in for sure. Sometimes you can cut a little too much off on accident. And a little more here. I need my hammer. I need my 3-pound sledge, but I got my ball peen or whatever. My claw hammer will try that. Not quite heavy enough, but this guy off here. And then my knife's over here. To unwrap a bunch of new blades here before I can finish. Edge over here on this other little portion of the wall is very small. Just over here. This guy here is on the verge of being almost too small to cut off, but it's not going to tuck in all the way. So I got all this stuff in the way over here. All the internet stuff. Turn my blade around to get a sharp spot. And try to shave that off.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to the camera. Because I'm recording a YouTube video. What are you up to?
Just camera.
You just come to help out a little. That's cool. You're a helpful little helper. Yeah.
What is cutting a coffee?
I am cutting it.
Why are you cutting it?
Because that's what you gotta do. You're silly.
Do I hear this funny noise? My funny noise maker?
Is that your little funny noise? What kind of little...
Funny
Let's see what kind of funny. Ah, do it again. Oh, that's scary. That is scary. Right there.
Watch this funny one. It's a fox.
Oh, no. That's terrible. It tooted. Oh, no.
That's funny.
You hear right here?
My camera watch is watching you.
I found the noise right here.
That's what the squeak is? Oh Lord!
What
are those? Yeah, in order to fix that squeak over there, I would have to roll the carpet all, get the couch out of here, roll the carpet all the way back over there,
yeah.
Or cut it open over there and roll it all back.
Can you put a nail in there? Will it work?
Not through the carpet, no.
I don't want you to cut my carpet.
Next, we're gonna go. We'll seam the doorway together here next. Guys, I'm gonna try to show as much of this as I can. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna stretch that wrinkle out. And there's also one over there as well. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna cut the carpet at the door seam. See if I can find a sharp edge on the razor first. We'll cut through. And then we'll go to the next step, where I pull the carpet up. It's been used over there. That's a sharp side there. Now, I usually finish this out with scissors, most often. Wow, I went to pick up the carpet and I pulled a couple fibers out, just falling apart. It's not a good sign. All right, now, make sure we're all watching the right spot here. All right, you can kind of see where the line goes, and then just good old common sense will kind of tell you where to cut. And if you mess up a little bit, you can fix it. So the one good thing about this is if you make a mistake, I rarely do, but if you make a mistake, that's more room for learning. You get to learn how to fix the mistake you made. So what I've always done was be really, really careful not to make a mistake. And if you do, you get the opportunity to learn how to fix it, because it's going to be right by the time I leave. So a lot of the times when I walk in the house, I don't know how I'm going to get the carpet stretched, but I'm going to find out before I leave. This is Corey. Hello. I hate those calls. There's someone calling to try to sell me something that's on the list. I just block the number. They can't call back again. They don't even talk. They just hang up. Auto dialer. I try to be polite as I can whenever a solicitor calls. I ask him if you're calling to schedule a carpet cleaning or carpet repair. And if they're not, you got the wrong guy. Because you're going to call this number. It's to schedule a carpet cleaning, a carpet repair. The answer's anything but that. He caught me when I was working. Can't help you. Call me about midnight. When I went home. Solicitors hate me. But that's okay. Alright, I forgot to change the foot out on the machine. I've got to change the foot out on it. And then I'm going to stretch this guy together here. So I'm going to change it out real quick and I'll be right back. All right. Now we're going to stretch this together and I should have somebody else to run a camera. I don't know where to put the camera at. I like to have it from an elevated position here. I just don't have that handy. I guess maybe we'll watch from just a little bit higher, sitting on top of something. You can see one wrinkle. So I'm going to start in the middle. About three different pulls. On the side. What I did on this particular one here, if you push the handle all the way down, it overstretches it. So what I did was I put this on the ratcheting part. It'll hold it where I need it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put some stay nails in it here on both sides. And I'm going to move this guy over here and do the same thing and put some more stay nails. And then I will cut. It looks like it's going to go over a little bit there for sure. So I'm going to seam that back together. So here's everybody's favorite thing for me to do is apply nails. Every once in a while, somebody likes to pipe up and go, "You shouldn't use nails. You shouldn't use nails." Okay. Don't use them if you don't want to. Prefer to use nails to hold the carpet because it doesn't. Good job. Makes my job a little easier. Other than I don't know how else to hold it. And this particular pattern works better when you have one holding behind the other one, because one nail in a row doesn't do as good as two or three or four nails holding together. That holds it a lot better in place. So I find. Okay, do that again. Here. Yeah, quite a bit's gonna come off. Hammer, where you at? moving along here. Now you'll notice that the wrinkle is gone. And the wrinkle over there is gone. So I'm gonna cut in here and this corner here, and I'm gonna make a few cuts and relieve the tension on it. And then I'll make the cut when I get ready to make the cut and start seaming it together. I will turn the video back on. For now, I gotta go. All right, here we are. I'm gonna take off not that much. I figured there'd been a little more. Maybe it's more over here. I don't know, we'll find out. Flatten everything out as much as I can. And let me share the reasoning behind what I'm doing here. Doorways, you can't really find one that doesn't have a seam. That's just where carpet seamed at the doors for sure. So cutting through here is not the best time you'll ever have. So this side, I opted to cut through this side. So I put this area over the top, put this over the top of that, so I'm going to make my cut on the area without the tape. That is a small bit of info that will help quite a bit if you are trying to figure this stuff out on your own with nobody to help you. I'll always try to bind up in the tape the razor. Just because it's a razor doesn't mean it's going to cut through the tape all that easy. And right here, I'm going to finish out my cut with my scissors here. Or they call them napping shears for the person that wants to be correct. For that guy out there somewhere that's watching. And this guy a couple weeks ago, he made some comments about I should buy a power stretcher, and the nails weren't necessary. And so what I did was I blocked that guy. You can't do that, man. Got three power stretchers here, and I do this a lot, so. You know, you can't chime in with something sarcastic and I'm not gonna let you make it. I'm gonna block you. I'm not gonna be rude, but I'm gonna block you. So we don't do any more of that, because this whole channel is not about wise comments and sarcasm. I'm here to help some people that have questions, and most of the people that will make a nasty comment, you go to their page and they have zero videos and zero subscribers. So unless you can show me on your YouTube channel, don't comment. There's only a couple guys that can comment, you know, and have merit. Guy out of Dallas is really good. He can, and there's several other guys that are really good at what they do, and I will send those guys work. Guy out of Dallas, I sent him a job last week. Because somebody saw one of my videos and they just wanted to ask me some questions, and they weren't around, they were in Dallas. So I referred them to a really respected carpet man in Dallas. I'll help you out. If you're someone in a different state or a different city, and I know who you are, and I respect you and the work that you do, I will gladly send you work in your city if someone comes to me and asks, you know, who do I get to help me? I'll help you out. But if you make sarcastic comments, I can't help you. That's my soapbox for a minute there. provided both of those extension cords will reach. Getting ready to seam some carpet together here. Cut the camera off for a minute and save a little battery, and when I get done with this, we'll take another look at it, and then we'll go downstairs and start down there. Okay, we're officially done upstairs. So let's take a look here. And everything tucked in and seamed back together, and the seam turned out really good for a carpet that's got this much wear on it. Can't see it if you didn't do it, pretty much. All right, now downstairs we go. And I'm actually limited on battery, so I don't know how much the video will show. I'll probably show a beginning and end downstairs because battery's not gonna make it. All right, guys, we're downstairs and I am tired. Just got there moving a bunch of furniture around. I'll show you what we're doing here. Just moved out this gigantic piece of furniture that was right here. Scooted this heavy bed out, with help, of course. Now, the wrinkles are here, basically. And there might be a little... There's a few over here, but not really that big of a deal. But I'm not going to stretch the room that way into the tile. I'm going to stretch it over here toward the windows. And again, this one, the way I'm going to do it is I'm going to stretch the room a little bit and then push the bed in the direction that I'm stretching. That's how that's going to work out. But this, you want to get the vacuum to vacuum up some of this stuff here. And I am going to plug this little camera in and try to get a little battery on it because it's just about to turn off right now. So I'm going to cut it off and plug it in, and I think I can maybe finish out this video tonight. Alright guys, I have a little vacuuming going on in the room in there, so I'm going to go in there in a minute. The customer is doing some vacuuming. All the wrinkles are stretched out, but we'll go take a look. What's going on is the carpet was creased for so long that even though the wrinkles are stretched out of it, you can see it, and we're vacuuming over it. We're doing everything we can to try to make it where you can't see it as much, but you're always going to be able to see it, because when people would get out of bed, they stepped on the wrinkle and they folded it. So it's like if you were to crease a piece of paper, you can iron it out and make it flat again, but you'll still be able to see where it was creased. So that's where we're at with the carpet. Let's go in there and we'll take a look around. I don't know if I'll be able to talk or not, but I'll point out where we're at. See where the main issue is the bed, where people would get out of bed and they would step on the wrinkle. So I'm gonna go in there and I'm going to tuck the carpet in, I'm gonna cut it off, and try to find a way to finish the video here. It's been a long day. I think it's about a little after 10 now. terribly long day. I'm gonna go try to get this finished up, and I will try to bring a conclusion to the video in just a few minutes. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll be right back one more time. All right, we are finished stretching the carpet now. This is what I got off here. This right here. This here is what's left. Tomorrow I'm gonna try my hardest to squeeze these guys in and clean just this one room so I can make this line go away, and it'll just look a whole lot nicer and clean it. All right, guys, I am terribly tired. I'm going to cut the camera off and pack up my stuff and go home and get some sleep. I appreciate you watching. Please subscribe, like, share, all that stuff. It's all appreciated. God bless.